Hi everyone. We have exciting news to share. As we're able to slowly move back to in-person events, we will have our first code jam for UF5 in a long time, happening on July 1st in Walldorf, Germany. It will be a full day of learning UF5, coding, and connecting with fellow developers as well as community members. All skill levels are welcome, so from absolute beginner to expert, everyone's welcome. And if that sounds interesting to you, check out the event listing below and sign up for it. And I see you there.
The new version of the SAP Mobile Startup has quite some highlights ready for you. One of the biggest is that the app is now available on Android and you can download it over the Google Play Store today. Other updates are MDM support, where MDM stands for Mass Device Management. That means the app has an easy app configuration available. Not only that, but both the Android and iOS app are updated to the brand new and, in my honest opinion, gorgeous SAP Fiori Horizon theme. And lastly, we enhance notification and task handling for SAP Mobile Start in a way that you can see notifications within a dedicated notification center, which is accessible from all main screens of the app. The latest tasks are now available on the start screen of the app to ensure that you do not miss any tasks given to you. At the moment, the new tasks feature is only available on iOS, but will be shipped for Android with its next release. If you want to have a full overview, check out my good friend Thilo Burns' blog post on blogs.sap.com.
Whether it's the hands-on SAP devs live streams, SAP community calls, or increasingly the return of hybrid and in-person events like SAP Code Jams or UI5Con, there are so many activities happening in the SAP community, it might be difficult to keep track of it all. To help you, we've recently launched the new SAP Community Events functionality. You get a quick calendar overview of all events, or you can view them by event type. You can also subscribe and be notified by mail whenever a new event is announced. Online events embed the YouTube details, adjust the date and time automatically to your profile settings, and allow you to easily add a reminder to your calendar. In-person and hybrid events have the same functionality, plus map location details. So the next time you want to check out what is happening in the SAP community, you know you have this great new event functionality to help keep you up to date.
SAP Conversational AI came out with its latest quarterly release. Here are three of the top features. One, you can now build FAQ chatbots by importing the questions and answers via an API, and not just by uploading a CSV file. You call the API and use scripting to transform the response into the format needed by the chatbot. Two, you can now automatically fetch CSRF, cross-site request forgery, tokens and cookies before making an API call. This is especially important for S4HANA calls. In destinations, you can add an SAP Conversational AI specific property with the path to the token endpoint. And three, all new SAP Conversational AI subscriptions will be based on Identity Authentication Service, or AIS, instead of XS UAA. No worries, XS UAA-based subscriptions will still be supported. You can get all the information in Paul Pinard's recent blog. A link to it is in the description.